So Time Magazine knew about this way back in 2004. You can't see that very well, but that says February 23rd, 2004. Time Magazine, the cover illustration, The Secret Killer, The Surprising Link Between Inflammation and Heart Attacks, Cancer, Alzheimer's, and Other Diseases, and What You Can Do to Fight It. That's 15 years ago. So why is your doc still focused on cholesterol? It's a good question. And there is a little something to cholesterol. It's not a totally negligible. However, why are docs still continuing to fail to focus on inflammation? I get a lot of questions about inflammation. That's one of the key components of this channel. I've developed a course on it, and I'll talk a little bit about that course. We had a question recently about one of the inflammation tests. There are tests that you can do to see how much inflammation you have going on. What is inflammation? Well, we'll cover a little bit of that in this discussion as well. And then we'll talk about how, just like everything else, it gets complicated. The bottom line is, what is inflammation? It's where your own immune system is attacking your body for one reason or another. This is a diagram of plaque. This is your immune system cells going. This is the bloodstream. This is your immune system cells going in to attack plaque. Now, again, and then we'll get back to the comment on how to find the course. This course, by the way, it takes about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours total. And once you take the course, you can understand what is inflammation, why is it important, what are the tests involved in looking for your own inflammation, how to get those tests, what the major causes are for that test, including, if you've watched any of the videos on this channel, at least a third of them talk about the number one cause, insulin resistance. But it doesn't get that much further into insulin resistance. We have a different course on that. This course, by the way, we've just put up recently. We made it a couple of months ago, started releasing it in more of a beta version. It's already become very popular. We've gotten a lot of focus on it and a lot of interest. Now, how do you find it? You go to our PrevMed website. This is what it looks like. And then you scroll down. You used to have a little banner, a black banner up at the top. That doesn't get there now. You scroll down. In fact, I'll show you. Before I do, let me make a couple of other plugs. We're having an event in Louisville where we actually offer cardiovascular inflammation testing, insulin resistance testing, the CIMT. We go deep in terms of why do any cholesterol testing, what you can get out of it. We provide all these tests and we provide CIMT, and we spend a couple of days talking about it and talking about your results and where you can go from there. If you opt into the evaluation version, you get a complete 101 evaluation with myself and with Janice, our health coach, as well. But let's get back to some more comments about LPPLA2. This discussion about Plaque2 was started by Patrick Neighbors. Basically, he said, thanks for your videos. I've been doing some good work. He started on a Crestor, started cutting his carbs. Then he made significant improvement in his Plaque2. But he began to wonder about which Plaque2. And just like we said before, everything gets really complicated. This is another version or image of Plaque2 and what it is. You see macrophages and monocytes come in from the bloodstream here, go through the endothelium or intimal cell layers, and then start getting hooked into trying to dissolve this light orange looking stuff, and in this case it's plaque. One thing you find out is that plaque 2 is actually a marker for thin capped necrotic plaque, meaning what many people used to think of was a vulnerable plaque. What we now realize is there is no such thing as the vulnerable plaque. If you've got a plaque process going on and you've got this activity going on with monocytes and other immune cells attacking that plaque, then what you have is cardiovascular inflammation. So again, this is one of the key tests for cardiovascular inflammation. Now, as you see here, we covered this in another video, but Cleveland Heart, as well as Mayo and some of the others, have recently gone from a concentration test to an activity assay. Now, what does that mean? Again, gets a little bit complicated, but bear with me for about 2 minutes and I'll get through the complicated stuff. But first, very quickly, what is plaque 2? Lipoprotein-associated phospholipase. One of the things that's important about that is it's lipoprotein-associated. So what happens is this. They found that in the earlier concentration studies and immunoassay studies, mass spec studies, what they were getting was plaque 2 that was linked or bound to that lipoprotein. Because remember, plaque 2 is working on the LDL in that lipoprotein and oxidizing it. So from many perspectives, many people think that it is an actor, an active component of cardiovascular inflammation. As we get deeper into a recent study that just, again, helps to underline the complication of the labs associated here, they're correlating activity versus concentration. Here they're correlating activity versus the immunoassay. What's an immunoassay? It's ELISA, enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. It's where you incubate the enzymes with a marker and then take a look at that marker on a gel plate. Again, I told you I was only going to go a couple of minutes into the complicated stuff, but let's get back up to what is this testing and how to find the inflammation panel, the inflammation course, the inflammation discussion. This is another image of what many would consider a vulnerable plaque. As you see here, the intimal cells at the top are getting worn out, look like they're getting ready to pop. This image actually came from an article where there were several trials looking at different drugs which might actually stop or decrease the activity of plaque 2. That's how much focus has gone into trying to manage this inflammation process. Bottom line was those studies were not successful. So I've gone from maybe 10,000 feet way down into the weeds very quick. Let's get back up to about 10,000 feet. How do you find the inflammation course? You go to our website, you follow the arrows down. Again, it used to be on a black banner up here. You follow the arrows down and you get to this part right at the bottom of the front page, the home page on our website. Again, maybe I've taken too long to talk about some simple items. I just wanted to make folks aware that we have this resource available. It's only a couple of hours, and we also have some other things available as well to help you sift through the complications of evaluating your own heart attack and stroke risk. Thank you for your interest.
Do you have bleeding when you go to the dentist or when you do a dental floss? If you do, be very afraid. Not of the dentist, of dental flossing. Be very afraid of heart attack and stroke, thinking insulin resistance, prediabetes, diabetes. Thanks.